guys, you are welcome back. I'm Faith Uche, and in this channel, I help provide solutions to issues affecting marriages and relationships. I also upload lifestyle videos like this one. So if it sounds like what resonates with you, please subscribe and hit on the notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. So after my wedding, I was hoping we'd get pregnant immediately, but I did not get pregnant immediately, so I thought I had serious issues that was delaying the pregnancy, not knowing that God has a different plan for me. So I'm grateful to God the way things turned out, because that period I was not pregnant gave me enough time to bond well with my husband, and it helped me to like adjust in the marriage before I start taking care of babies. Might not know everything about somebody before you get married. There is difference between staying with somebody in the house and just visiting. So it's gave me enough time to do so. So when you start experiencing delay pregnancy in your marriage, don't conclude immediately that you might be having issues. Allow God to do his thing. God might have a different plan for you. So don't be too quick to be very worried about it. So how it happened was, there was this day I went to work, and I went to the restroom at my place of work. And before I could finish from the restroom, I noticed some blood spots. And I was worried because I was not on my monthly flow. But before then, I had pregnancy discharge. Unknown to me that it was pregnancy discharge. So I went to buy infection drug for it to treat it. It's not as if I went for any test to confirm that it was infection. It was just self-medication. So for some reasons, I did not take that drug. Please do not self-medicate. Avoid self-medication, because I don't know what would have happened if I had taken that drug. Later on, after I saw that spot, and then I remembered that I was having discharge, maybe that was why I did not take that drug. So I combined both together, and then I decided to like do a pregnancy urine test at home. So this is the results of the test. When I first saw the line, I was skeptical because it's very faint, so I gave it to my husband to look at it for me. He was convinced it's positive, but I was not. So I did another test that came out with same results. So I went for a medical blood test the following day to confirm if I was really pregnant. The results also came out positive. But still, I was still having my doubts, although I was happy. Till I started experiencing those pregnancy symptoms, I thought maybe it was just a normal sickness. It was not until my tummy started to show and I started experiencing my baby kick, that was when I started to believe that I'm pregnant. I don't know if I'm just doubting Thomas. So that was when I really started to believe that I was pregnant. So the whole first trimester thing was really a tough experience for me. Morning sickness thing started immediately after I missed my first period, and it was not easy at all. I was not only having it in the morning, I was having it in the morning, afternoon, evening. There were days at night when I would wake up and I would just start to cry. And then I'll wake my husband. I was like, so you are sleeping and I'm here crying. You are busy sleeping. Who put me in this situation? And you have the nerve to sleep. I will just be picking up unnecessary quarrels. It does not require to get angry. I would be angry. So guys, first trimester was not really easy. The portion of food I started eating was very small. There were days when I would eat white rice without stew or any protein, meat or fish on it. I'll just eat it like that, just so that the baby will have something to feed on. It was not as if I even want to eat. And that time I was craving for plenty of pepper, thinking that if I had so much pepper on the food, it will make me to stop to spit, because I was spitting a lot. So there was a day I prepared stew. Nobody else could eat that food. I was the only one that could eat it. Days I was depressed. Depression in pregnancy is real. What helped me was I always seek the advice from my doctor. Whenever I feel that way, I would just call her, and then she would tell me to do some certain things. And I just go out, maybe go to work, because I have my own business I'm running, so I could decide to like stay at home. But when I'm feeling that way, I would just decide to like go to work so that I can see people to prevent me from having negative thoughts in my head. You know that when you are always alone, evil thoughts will start coming, coupled with the fact that I was pregnant. So I would just go out from the house, see people, and then talk to families and friends. So they really helped a lot to help me cope with depression. Please, if you experience depression in pregnancy, don't be a superwoman saying that you can handle it all by yourself. Seek help from medical personnel, or call your families, talk to friends. Just seek help. Don't bottle up everything inside thinking that you can handle everything all by yourself. It does not work that way. Depression in pregnancy is real. So there was this fateful day. First trimester, show me shege. There was this fateful day. My neighbor was holding a party, and we were not invited to that party. But they were cooking close to my house, and then I perceived the aroma of that food. All this while I could not eat, but that particular food I perceived. Oh God, I started craving for that food. It was jollof rice. I started craving for that food, and then I went inside. I told my husband that I want to eat that food. He was like, we were not invited to that party. How do you expect me to go to that place to get food? I did not answer him. I said, is that food I want to eat? So he had to like call his mom. And then his mom told him that, quick, go and beg for that food for her. She has not been eating since. And now she says she wants to eat. You are there having options. Because he was like, okay, he should go to a fast food to get me food. But I said, no, I don't want any food from fast food. I want that particular food. So my husband does not have a choice than to go to the place and beg for that food. So when he brought the food, I finished it. But I could not eat ever since. When he brought that particular food, I finished it, finished all the protein. So I'll tell you that pregnancy could turn you to something else sometimes. This was when I finished eating the food. I started dancing to the party song, like someone that is not normal, just to take my mind off reality of pregnancy. So this video is an unaware video. My brother was doing this video unknown to me, so he sent it to me later on. And if you are wondering why we are not invited to that party, it's because it's an house opening party, and we are not familiar with the owner of the house at that time. It was just cold water I was able to drink. Please, I'm not saying you should drink cold water because it's not good for the baby. That was what I could drink at first trimester. Second trimester was really the honeymoon of pregnancy for me. Second trimester was, in short, I would say it was sweet. Second trimester was easy. It was easy. I started feeling so relaxed. I started enjoying my pregnancy at second trimester. I was no longer depressed. I could smile and play with Obi and just enjoy the moment at second trimester. Unlike first trimester, I was finding it difficult to smile because I was always depressed. So it was really nice. I started doing interesting things and just enjoy the moment. Live each day as it comes. I was comfortable with the smell from food. because before second trimester, at first trimester, I was going about in the house with face masks so that I would not perceive the smell from food. But from second trimester, I could stay without face mask. It was okay for me. I started enjoying things better. Towards the end of second trimester, I did a scan that identified the sex of the baby.
The head area?
Wow. That's in between his ears.
That's the head. That's around the head area. That's the head.
Check the sex again.
It's still a woman now. Not the woman I tell you before.
No, you see me back.
So I started buying my baby's item at third trimester. I should have started buying it early, but I thought I should know the sex of the baby first. And it affected me so much because I was always tired at first trimester. So waiting till then to shop for my baby was really a big mistake I made. At third trimester, you are close to delivery. So any little mistake you make could affect the baby and it could affect you. So I did a separate video on how I almost had a preterm labor. So if you've not watched that video, after you watch this one, you can go and watch that one. I explained everything in detail there. The first day my baby kicked, I was so excited. It was second trimester I noticed the first movement, but she started kicking a lot at third trimester. And this feeling is so refreshing and satisfying, knowing that your baby is doing great inside. And I was nesting a lot. If you don't know what nesting is, it's trying to like clean the house, put things in order before the arrival of your baby. So I was doing that a lot. So this is past midnight when I'm supposed to be sleeping, but I wasn't. I was still nesting, even with my 90s on. Who does that? So I was hoping to continue the next day to finish arranging the room, but I couldn't because the next day was delivery. So if you want me to do a video on my delivery, please let me know in the comment section. So pregnancy is not easy at all. Women are trying. Women are really trying. It's not easy. When I experienced all of this and I knew what my mom passed through, I called and I was like, ah, mom, you try, you. How many children? You went through all of this and you have 5. How come? So guys, that was what I went through in pregnancy. Pregnancy is really beautiful though, even with all the palaver. When you finally meet your baby, you will forget everything you went through. And you will see that when you carry your baby in your arms, you're like, oh, it's worth it. Everything I went through is worth it. Do not be scared of pregnancy because of all these things you just heard. Pregnancy is really beautiful. It's something all women should experience. When you finally meet your baby, you will be so happy and you will smile just as I'm smiling now. So pregnancy is really a thing of joy. It's something to experience by all women. And if you are praying for the fruits of the womb, do not lose hope. Know that God is there. He has not forsaken you. He will not leave you, he said so himself. So know that he will give you a child at his own due time. And you know God's time is always the best. His time is never late. For my single ladies out there, do not allow anybody to deceive you into being a single mom. To be a single mom is not easy. To carry pregnancy alone, it's not even easy for married couples, let alone for a single parent. There were days that it's just me and my husband. He was my pillar. So if you're single, being a single mom, who will be your pillar in those days when you will need the support that comes from having a companion? So please don't allow anybody to cajole you into being a single parent, being a single mom, carrying pregnancy all by yourself. It's not easy to carry pregnancy all by yourself. So guys, we have come to the end of this video. Please give it a thumbs up and let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Share your thoughts with me if you felt similar things I went through in pregnancy. And please subscribe to this channel. See you in the next one. Bye for now.